Biology.
Very much welcome there to this class, whereby today we are going to discuss about excretion and homeostasis. So let's first of all define what is excretion. So excretion is basically the removal of metabolic waste from the bodies of organisms. So these waste may include carbon dioxide, different nitrogenous waste, excess water, mineral salts, also we have tannins, or excess quinine, and resins. So if these substances are left in the body, however, we see that they will be toxic. So waste should always be removed as quickly in the body as they are produced. So the metabolic processes also releases heat and changes of pH in the body. So therefore, a constant environment must always be maintained by the body, which is referred to as homeostasis. So what is homeostasis? So homeostasis, we'll define it as, this is the maintenance of a constant internal environment of the body. Also, let's define ingestion as well as secretion. So what is ingestion? So ingestion is basically the removal of undigested and indigestible food materials from the body or food vacuoles of the cell. So what is secretion? So secretion is the release of useful substances produced by the cells, such as the hormones, we have the enzymes, we have the oxalates and sebum, and finally we have the mucus. So let's jump in excretion in plants and look on how excretion in plants basically takes place. So you see that plants have various excretory waste, like for example carbon dioxide, oxygen, excess water, sap, resins, and gums. So they, however, do not have an elaborate excretory organ or excretory system as compared to the animals. So this is because the waste in plants accumulate very slowly. Also, the waste of the plants are basically carbohydrates, whereby you see that carbohydrates are always less toxic as compared to the amino acids, the proteins, and the fats found in the animals. So you see that the waste in the plants are always stored in a less harmful state. And also the nitrogenous waste in the plants is always used to synthesize new proteins. Also for the waste in plants, you see that the waste in plants are always recycled, whereby we have carbon dioxide and oxygen, which are used in the dark stage and the light stage phase of photosynthesis respectively. Also you see that the waste in plants are always converted to a less toxic substance. So what are the different uses of these excretory products in plants? Whereby we see that the first one, we have caffeine. So caffeine is basically obtained from tea and coffee plants. What are the uses of caffeine? We see that they are used as mild stimulant and also to produce and manufacture different insecticides. So apart from caffeine, we also have cocaine, whereby cocaine is obtained from the coca plant. For the uses of cocaine, it is used to in the manufacture of local anesthesia and also induce euphoria. So the other product of the plant, we have quinine, whereby it is obtained from the cinchona plant. What are the uses of quinine? So quinine, they always act as anti-malaria drug. So apart from that, we also have nicotine, which is basically obtained from the tobacco plant. So what are the uses of nicotine? So the first use of nicotine is that it acts as the central nervous system stimulant or the CNS stimulant. And also nicotine is highly carcinogenic, meaning that it can cause cancer. So apart from that, we also have morphine, which is basically obtained from the opium poppy plant. What are the uses of morphine? The first use of morphine is that it induces sleep and then it also causes hallucinations. And also morphine is used in hospitals as pain reliever, since it is a very strong pain reliever. So the other product is atropine, whereby this atropine is basically obtained from thorn apple, commonly referred to as Datura plant. So for the thorn apple, the scientific name is Datura stramonium. So it's Datura stramonium as the scientific name of the thorn apple. And also the function of this thorn apple or atropine product as excreted by the plant. So the first function is that it increases the heartbeat. And then the other function is that it is highly poisonous. So the other product we have is colchicine, which is basically obtained from the autumn crocus plant. So for this colchicine, it's basically used as cancer therapy, and also it induces polyploidy process in plants. So we also have rubber, whereby it is basically obtained from the latex or the rubber plant. But what are the uses of rubber? It is used in the shoe industry, but also in the manufacture of different chewing gum. So apart from that, we also have cannabis, whereby it is obtained from the bark plant. So the bark plant, the scientific name as commonly known, it is the cannabis sativa plant. What are the used, what are the uses of the cannabis? So the cannabis is basically used in the manufacture of different drugs, legal and illegal drugs. So apart from that, we also have cat, whereby this cat is obtained from the cat plant, or the scientific name of the cat plant is Cata edulis. And what are the functions of the cat? So the function of the cat is that they serve as, they act as medicinal drugs, whereby a patient may be prescribed to take the cat. Also for the cat, we see that it is a mild stimulant. And also for the cat, we see that it basically leads to impotence of the males. So lastly, let's look at heroin, whereby heroin is obtained from opium poppy plant, just as morphine was obtained from opium poppy plant. And what are the uses of heroin? So the first use of heroin, we see that it basically induces drug dependence. And the second use of heroin drugs, we see that it is highly addictive. And then lastly, for the heroin drug, we see that it is a narcotic drug. Now let's meet on the next class as we now look on excretion and homeostasis in animals. Biology.